Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Miami High School and this evening's Superintendent Honors Music Festival 2022. Yes, you can clap. My name is Patricio Suarez. I am the Director of Performing Arts for Miami-Dade County Public Schools, overseeing all performing arts from music, theater, and dance. And it is an honor to be with you here this evening. This is about the 30th year that this event has been going on, and it is an honor to be selected to perform on this stage with students from around Miami-Dade County. We would like to give a couple of thanks to a couple of people before we get started. We're going to make it nice and short. We'd like to welcome Mr. Carranza from the STEAM Academic Advisor here. Also, we'd like to thank the administration, Principal Benny Valdez from Miami High, Marisol Rivera, the Activities Director, and Ms. Sid and Mr. Santiago, the music teachers here at Miami High, for hosting us here. We'll round of applause for them. We'd also like to thank all the teachers and principals and administrators from other schools that have come out to support their schools, so let's give a round of applause for them. And without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, we open up our show with the middle school chorus.
Yeah. Holocaust is a stunning reminder of the tragic results of prejudice and hate towards other people. But it is also a reminder that hope held firm will eventually reign victorious over the greatest of odds. The following words were inscribed on the walls of a southern Cologne, Germany, where Jews were hiding from the Nazis during World War II. Hope was all they had to hold on to. Hope was their only bridge to a brighter tomorrow.
Thank you.
you, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give up for our middle school chorus. And before we release these students, our coordinator and accompanist, Mr. Eric Firestone from South Miami Middle. And of course, our amazing conductor, Dr. Leslie Allen Denny from New World School of the Arts. Thank you, gentlemen, for your amazing work. And thank you, students, for that great opening to our Superintendent's Honors Music Festival. Thank you. Let's give it up one more time for them. Conductor, Dr. Aaron Millard from Florida International University.
keep it brief. This is one of the most prepared and talented honor choirs I have ever worked with. So first, I just want to thank these students. You are amazing. You're so amazing. What a treat it was for me. Second of all, I would really like to thank their music educators. They are some amazing people. These students are wonderful musicians. So if you just could please, they're all over the place. They're making everything happen behind the scenes. We can take a chance just to thank them. Their music educators, please. Before we get into our final piece, which is going to be Let Everything That Have Breath, arranged by Jeff Ames from Belmont University, we talk a lot about music education. If you're enrolled in music education, you have higher SAT scores, and you have a higher GPA, and you're better at math, and nobody on stage is in music for those reasons. Those are benefits. That is not the value of music. The value of music is that these students find ways through music to process what they're going through every day, to connect with things that we're doing together. And I want to thank you for supporting them as they continue to have a relationship with music, and I hope that you will always do that. Thank you so much for being here tonight.
To the Lord.
Elizabeth Sid from here, but our amazing conductor, Dr. Karen Gillard. Thank you. Once again for that amazing, amazing high school chorus. Ladies and gentlemen, before we continue our program, we have a very special guest with us that I'm going to welcome to the stage, Dr. Sylvia Diaz, Chief Academic Officer of Miami-Dade County Public Schools. Give it up for her.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. This beautiful auditorium, this beautiful evening, this is my alma mater. So I'm very fond of Miami-Dade and being in this auditorium brings back a lot of memories. But I want to thank all of you all. I want to thank the parents for all that you do for your children, to support them, the extra hours of practice, all of the running around. I want to thank the teachers who put in all that extra time to work and to bring these types of events to fruition and to help our children succeed in all sorts of different ways, academically and in terms of the arts and all that we do. And I want to thank the kids. The reason that I come to work, I go to work every morning, is children and what it means to our society. So thank you. I know that this is a beautiful event, and I will let it continue.
Thank you, Dr. Diaz. Middle School Orchestra.
Thank you. 1980, I was a student sitting probably in one of those chairs. This is my alma mater, so this is a very, very special place for me. So I'm honored that today, parents, teachers, guest conductors, community members are out here celebrating music and celebrating the incredible talent that our students hold. After what we've been through, we need this, right? We need students, we need orchestra, we need chorus, we need band, and what a beautiful night to really come and celebrate with the incredible talent that we have in this school district. I just wanted to come by 2-3 minutes to enjoy what is still to come, but really thank the incredible work of the teachers again, of the guest conductors, of our district department that brings all of this together for a joyful celebration of music and the arts that are really part, that should be part of every student's experience in school. It is not only about academics, but it's also about fine arts and all the other talent areas that our students really need exposure to. Thank you so very much, and continue to enjoy the party.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our conductor for the middle school band, Oliver Diaz, for the Teacher of the Year.
Thank you. Thank you so much, everyone. As our percussionists are getting ready for our final piece, which features the percussion family, I want to thank DCBA and FBA District Chair Ken Torgerson for this incredible honor and privilege to be able to conduct an incredible, incredible band. Please give them another round of applause for these fantastic students. I would very briefly like to thank my two coordinators, Francisco Williams and David Gonzalez, for all their help backstage. All the my colleague conductors that helped during rehearsals, thank you so much for all your help. I'd like to point out, we had a percussionist who joined us very last minute because we had a part that needed to be filled in, so she's not in the program, but Chloe Napolis, thank you so much, Chloe, for helping us out. Aramis Gonzalez and the Fort Park High School band staff for accommodating our rehearsals. Just a wonderful group of kids over there. Aramis, thank you so much. For all the directors and parents of these students, thank you for sharing those students with me. This has been a highlight, one of the highlights of my career. Me being an elementary teacher, it's just an honor to be conducting such an amazing group. Thank you to my family, my wife, my parents, my mother-in-law in the audience. Thank you so much for supporting me. And to make this even better for me, my two sons, Oliver Jr. and Matthew, congratulations for being here. And last but certainly not least, to these incredible students, as I told you last night, this has been an honor and a privilege, and I really hope you take this memory for a long time and enjoy it, and keep auditioning for honor bands and all state in your future. Thank you so much. We're going to have our final piece, Osmosis.
Thank you. conductor, Mr. Oliver Diaz.
Me and Oliver go way back. And ladies and gentlemen, also to our amazing conductors, David Gonzalez and Francisco Williams, who assisted. Thank you to them.
Thank you all for your support this evening. I'm very glad to be here. We are a lot quieter than those bands were, okay? So you'll have to turn off your phones and lend your ears, but we're gonna do our best to play some lovely guitar music for you. We have two songs from Austro-Hungary, and then one song by living, where was she from? Was that from Ukraine? By a living Belarusian composer. So please enjoy, I'll talk more as we go. This next song is a poem dedicated to music by Schubert. It's one of my favorite texts. He talks about the long hours he spent working on his craft, much like all these children have. They don't play this way because they learned yesterday. They've all been working on it for quite some years, and I'll give them a hand. I love you. I had a lovely clarinet player ready for you, but he got COVID. Isn't that the way we have now? Luckily, yesterday I called my friend Patrick, who is a lovely tenor from Michigan. He's a member of Seraphic Fire. I have some friends in that group, and I made the phone call, and here he is, just like that. That's why it's good to have friends. This is An die Musik by Franz Schubert. Please enjoy.
Oh,
have one more for you. I want to thank DCMEA and Miami High for hosting us. And thank you to these lovely kids, and thank you, parents. Have a nice night. Thank you.
Let's give a few minutes for second grade guitar.
This is the only ensemble that we have this evening that takes middle school and high school students. Let's give it up for them all and our amazing conductor, Mr. Alvaro Bermudez from Ronald Reagan Doral Senior High School. Thank you, Alvaro. And thank you again to these amazing students. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together and welcome the High School Orchestra.
Great experience for me and hopefully everyone on the stage playing with these wonderful musicians and the great teachers that have inspired them and inspire me. We're doing four short pieces. The first one is the Adagio and Fugue by Mozart. This is written towards the end of his life. He at the time was writing his three great symphonies, the three final symphonies. Those were without commission. He just wanted to write them and we're not even sure when they would premiere, even if they would premiere during his lifetime. This piece was commissioned by his publisher, which meant he made some money from it, and he was very excited to do it, and it's a glorious piece. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Our next work is The Waltz from the Tchaikovsky Serenade for Strings. Tchaikovsky wrote two pieces at the same time. One, like this Adagio and Fugue, was a commission by his publisher. He didn't like the piece very much, and he thought it really wasn't a very heartfelt, deep piece. It's called the 1812 Overture, a piece that we all love so much. But at the same time, he wrote a Serenade for Strings, which he thought was one of his greatest pieces and most joyful pieces. And by the way, Tchaikovsky's favorite composer was Mozart. He even wrote a piece called Mozartiana. So this is the waltz from the String Serenade.
Thank you.
next good play, a beautiful piece by an American composer named Arthur Foote. It's the first movement of his suite for strings. Arthur Foote was a very great, important composer in the latter part of the 19th century and early 20th century. He wrote this piece in 1907. He grew up, lived, and spent his life in Boston. He was among the first American-trained composers. He also was the first composer ever to get a master's degree in music. He went to the New England Conservatory when it first began, then he went to Harvard, and he was the first person ever to get a master's degree. Anyway, this is a great favorite of a very wonderful conductor named Serge Koussevitzky, who did so much to help the cause of great American music in the early part of the 20th century. So the first movement of the Suite for Strings. Next to George Gershwin, the most famous of the American composers, Aaron Copland. Copland was born in 1900 and died in 1990. And he, in a way, together with Gershwin, helped create American music. That's not to say there weren't other great composers before, and of course many since, but he purposely tried to create a sound that he thought was distinctively American, and he did it in very many different ways, but especially in his famous ballets, Billy the Kid, Rodeo, Appalachian Spring, Dance Palace. He was a remarkable composer, and Rodeo was choreographed by a very famous choreographer, Agnes DeMille, for the Ballet Russe de Monte Carlo. And the thing about Ballet Russe was that that was the same company that commissioned Stravinsky to do the Rite of Spring, Petrushka, Firebird. Fire did the three-cornered hat. All the great Prokofiev ballets were done for the Ballet Russe. But then they were now in Monte Carlo, and they commissioned this piece. The most famous movement is the what's the movement? The Hold Down, thank you. And Copland made a version for string orchestra. And so to end our little partner, and to be very grateful to all of you parents that care enough about wonderful music and the education of your kids to give them great music to sing and to play. To all the remarkable teachers that mean so much to us and have given all of us so much in our lives, in all of our lives. And so I thank you. I know we had yet the band. Band comes after us. It has to end with a band. But anyway, here's the Rodeo, the Codown of Baron Copeland.
For the High School Orchestra. And thank you to our amazing conductor, Maestro Charles Schultz from the University of Miami.
Thank you so much. Maestro, this is for you. Thank you so much for this. You sharing your talent with our amazing students. Thank you. And our coordinator, Ms. Rosa Rabinovich. Please welcome to the stage Professor Douglas McCullough from the University of Miami as the conductor for high school band.
Schools, the fact that they can produce students like this, wow. And the fact that they were so very generous to even ask me to come and conduct and work with these kids, three rehearsals and tonight's performance, I am totally honored. So congratulations to all those folks. Absolutely. Fantastic. I can go on and on and on, except it's a very late night, so I won't. But I can just tell you, these are really, you heard that they're good players. That's never as important to me as they are great people. And when the very first night we rehearsed for 4 hours, took a little dinner break in there, and to work with teenagers for 4 hours and not one time ask them to pay attention. Because they were always paying attention. Wow. That's something. So let me tell you, the first piece of music we played was a little short kind of opener thing called Burn. It was written for the Dallas Wind Symphony a few years ago, so I just thought it was a great way, because I knew it would be late by the time we got out here. I want to make sure everybody's awake. So now we're good. But this next piece, South Shore Soliloquy, was written to honor a band director, college band director by the name of Gary Corcoran, and he was the band director at
Pittsburgh University, and I always think Pittsburgh State, I always think that's in Pennsylvania, but it's actually in Kansas. So that's, you know, it was always hard for me to remember that, that some schools, like, you know, there's Indiana University, but it's in Pennsylvania, but there's a Miami of Ohio, and they've got it all confused. And a couple years from now, Miami of Ohio plays Miami, and then, you know, how does that work? So anyhow, we'll find out. But this piece of music reminds me of this, and I bet this will make sense too. This is for all the parents and grandparents in the audience. The students up here can't quite understand this, but they will someday. Don't you look at these fine young people every once in a while and go, wasn't it just a couple years ago I was taking them to first grade? Wasn't that just like just right before COVID? They were in first grade, and yet that was 9 or 10 or 11 years ago. How did that happen? And do you remember that was back when you could hold their hand when they went into school? They won't do that anymore. But remember how cool that was? And then do you remember when they brought their instrument home the very first time and they played, I don't know, Twinkle Twinkle or Mary Had a Little Lamb or something for you after they dumped it out of the case accidentally when they got it in the house? And then it sounded nothing like Mary or had no resemblance of the lamb. And yet, to you, it was beautiful. But remember what that was compared to what you just heard. How did we get to this? So, I think as we're playing this next piece, I want you to sit there and relax. This is really a simple piece, but very hard to play with the emotion that we're going to attempt to play it with. I want you to play back the film in your minds. Each one of you has a separate one. Think what they used to be. Think all that they've gone through. Think how fast, every once in a while you wish you could probably stop time, but we can't. They just keep growing up. But by the time we get to the very end of the piece, I bet you've come up with some really great memories, some of which they hope you never share with other people, but some great memories of these young people. And then when we get to the very end, look and see what they've become now and listen to how they sound now. It's pretty great also. So I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you. but I mean, he would have never said, you know, here's our four pieces, and here's why we're picking each one, and, you know, here's how they're going to work for the audience appeal, we try to always factor in what I hope you would enjoy tonight. I said, however, we really need to do these four well, because we need an encore. And it's going to be really awkward if there's no applause after the march, and we go, wait, there's four, because nobody wants anymore. But we told them that I always feel like a great concert is when it's over, you go, another song or two. Well, we have one. We don't have two. We have one. So, we'd like to play. Just about done, and it hit me during the march.
Thank you very much, sir. Have a good evening. One more time. And our coordinator, Katerina Papadopoulos. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, we conclude our Superintendent Honors Music Festival 2022. Thank you so much. Sorry about the delay, and get home safe. Thank you.